small words when we're writing our essays to make you sound more intelligent, smart, whatever word you want to use. This is the placemat that you're going to get. So depending on what you're working with, there's all types of different transitional words to help you out and to make your writing more advanced. So if you notice here, alternative, it gives you different words you can use. This is a big one. When you're writing your conclusions, 9 times out of 10, you're going to write what at the beginning of that paragraph? In conclusion. Okay, how many times has your English teacher told you don't put that? Every single time. So here are some alternatives. All things considered, to review, in closing, to sum up. Okay? So there's all, if you're going to do an example, instead of saying, for example, you can say, for instance. So as you're writing your SAQ, it's good to have some of these transitional words in here. When you're trying to make an emphasis on something, in particular, above all. Pretty good tool, yes? Okay. So this is going to be up here for you. So your little yellow Lego is if you find a transitional word. Okay? So I read Josh's, and his was good. So what we're going to do is I'm going to read his first SAQ to you, the silver only daughter. And we're going to build it together so that you understand what I'm looking for. All right? So you should have your little Legos on your desk. So the question was, what imagery does the author use to help you understand, how the author is feeling? That was our question. So the first thing he should have done is what? What's the first thing you should do?
Answer it.
Answer the question. So we're starting with Ace. How I feel myself being erased shows us that the reader feels lonely and forgotten. When reading this, the reader understands how she feels because the imagery is used in a feeling way. Okay? This is a very good start. Now, let's start with the first sentence, and you're going to build up. The first sentence says, imagery is used in a feeling sense in Only Daughter. What is that? What part of Ace is that? That's the A. That's the answer. So you're going to start with this Lego. Go ahead and pull this Lego up. All other Legos should be out of your hands. All right. His second sentence says, the quote, but somehow I can feel myself being erased, shows us that the writer feels lonely and forgotten. Now, each line, you should have two, with the exception of the assertion, because it's long, you should have two Legos per line. Okay, so this second sentence, what is it? So he did what? What do we call this? He embedded it. Okay, so this one sentence says, the quote, but somehow I can feel myself being erased, shows us that the writer feels lonely and forgotten. That is a well-written sentence. Yes? Yes, good job. Next sentence, so we have sentence one, and you can flip it this way if you want, how it looks for the paragraphs. We have the assertion in sentence one, and we have an embedded text with commentary in sentence two. You can either go up or you can go down. It doesn't matter. Okay, sentence one, sentence two. Sentence three says, when reading this, the reader understands how she feels because the imagery is used in a feeling way. What is that? That's just commentary. Okay. This is what his model looks like. Yes? How can we make this better? Right. How many examples of evidence does he have? One. We're still missing one. Okay. What else can make this better? What if he just added another sentence? Is that what we're looking for? No. What are we looking for? Okay. Well, we can add some transition in there. Okay. But we have sentence one, sentence two, sentence three, sentence four. So this model, how can we make it better? Because right now, he doesn't have the second evidence. He just has one. Add the second evidence, but how? Okay? What would make this even better? In that last?
Embedded.
Okay? What would make this even better? In that last sentence, do what as well? Add that transition. So this is the type of model that you are trying to achieve. Okay? Josh did a good job.
Your own?
Okay, your only daughter? All right. Okay, we'll stick with only daughter. This is Kennedy's. Thank you for being brave. I'm going to read it to you first, and then we'll go ahead and build it. All right, here we go. It says, in the story. pictures in my head using imagery. In the third paragraph, the story says, my brother felt it beneath them to play with the girl in public. This made me think of a little girl walking outside and expecting to play with her family, but they tell her that she can't play with them. Sandra later explains in the story that her father always said, I have siete, how do you say that?
Eagles.
Kids. Which meant sons, and she would always tug on his clothes and say, we had six sons and a daughter, not seven. Sarah was painting several pictures in my head using imagery. Didn't he answer the question? Specifically? How can we make that better? In the story of Only Daughter, Sandra Cisneros paints several pictures in my head using imagery. Paint several pictures in my head is dealing with what sense? Seeing. So, painting pictures is helping him to visualize what she's experiencing. Is that imagery? Yes, it is. He did answer the question. Okay? Line one here is his assertion. Line two, or sentence number two, in the third paragraph, the story says, my brothers felt it beneath them to play with a girl in public. What does it take to make up a sentence? Two. Sentence number two. Okay, so sentence number two only had text evidence in it. And two blocks make up, with the exception of the assertion, two blocks make up the sentence. We good so far? Sentence number three. This made me think of a little girl walking outside and expected to play with her family, but they tell her that she can't play with them. What is that? Commentary. Two blocks make up a sentence. There's sentence number three. Okay. Sentence number four. Sandra later explains in the story that her father always said, I have siete hijos, which meant sons, and... Okay. I'm going to say anything incorrectly. Which meant sons, and she would always tug at his clothes and say, we had six sons and a daughter. Now, that second part, we have text evidence. Let me just pull my extras over here. So we have evidence in there, right? And there's commentary in there, but is it giving that deeper meaning? No, basically he just reiterated what the story said, but in his own words. So it's commentary, yes, but it's not showing that he has a deeper understanding of it. Does that make sense? So I'm going to loosely put that one there. All right, so does he have two examples of text evidence? Commentary, right? But if we took sentence two and three and combined them together, it would be here. And then he had his text and he had his commentary in the next one, although it's loosely there because it's not showing that deeper understanding. But this is what we're looking for. Okay? Your ultimate goal is to get something that looks like this. Now, this transitional word, it could go in both, or it could go in one or the other. This is what we're striving for. Okay? So what I want you to do is I want you to read through yours. As you read through them, I want you to build your Legos. And this is going to help you see. I can tell you all day long, make sure you have this, this, and this. But this actually makes you see it. And you can see